Whether you need to create data-informed SEO content briefs for copywriters or SEO-optimized texts, the content marketing tool has got you covered.
To start working on a new piece of content in SEO ranking, go to the Content Marketing tool using the left-hand side menu, then navigate to Content Editor. There you will see a list of every content piece currently being worked on or already published. By clicking on the New Content button in the top right-hand corner, you will see a pop-up window that presents you with two options: Write New Brief and Article, and Optimize Existing Content. Since we're creating a new article, let's focus on the first option. Here, we can go as simple as to just specify our primary keyword as well as the target location and language. We could also provide more details by toggling on batch keyword analysis and specifying more keywords, as well as expanding additional settings and giving the article a name, specifying whether the article is intended to rank in desktop or mobile search, which determines the competition that will be taken into account during analysis, and specifying up to 5 competitors ranking outside the top 10 search results for the target keyword whose content you like and want to outrank. Note that if you perform batch keyword analysis, you won't be able to name the article or specify the competition here, but you'll be able to do it later on. When you're ready, hit create. Once the analysis is complete, you will be redirected to the actual content editor area where you can start working on the text. But before we do that, there are several options here you should know about. First, we have the Generate an Article with AI Writer button, which will take you through a step-by-step process where you can keep close tabs on everything the AI Writer generates. Then there's the Generate an Article in one-click option, which is pretty self-explanatory. And by pasting the structure, you can pull the predefined heading structure from the content brief, which should be empty at this stage. Speaking of the content brief, the blue brief button in the top right corner lets you dive deep into the content brief that specifies all of the details of the soon-to-be article. Let's explore the content brief in detail. If you have a good understanding of what works well in your niche or industry, and you want to take the optimization process under your close control, we encourage you to analyze and adjust the content brief settings as you see fit. Here, we first see the list of the article's competitors ranking among the top 10 search results for the target keyword, as well as those we've added manually. Make sure to analyze the data in the table, including the content score, domain and page trust scores, and the total number of words, to name a few, to determine if the competitors are indeed relevant to you in terms of the user search intent. By the way, you are welcome to deactivate irrelevant competitors as well as take advantage of the Add More Competitors from the SERP option below the table. Next, under Content Parameters, we automatically determine the recommended content parameters like word count, headings, paragraphs, and images based on the competitors selected for the analysis. You're free to change these values if you know for a fact that something else works better in your niche. Under Terms to Use, define which semantically related keywords must be used in the article so that it attracts the right audience. Here you can see a list of suggested terms which can be easily filtered, plus you're able to add keywords manually. Go through the list to find the most promising keywords and be sure to analyze essential SEO data like search volume, keyword difficulty, and importance, which is determined by how a term is used among various page elements or how well the page performs in search for the given term. One of the most convenient metrics here lets you know exactly where your competitors are placing keywords in their articles. Then we have the number of competitor pages the term is used on, recommended keyword count for your text, actual and average count, and the average density. Under Links, analyze the table data to make sure that your article includes every relevant internal and external link to help it pass link juice, get more search engine authority, and rank higher in search as a result. Under Questions, go through the list of questions pulled from various sources like People Also Ask and Top 10 Competitors to make sure you're answering them in your content. This can help you rank for conversational and informational queries, among other things. Under Heading Structure, you need to define the article's outline. You can do this manually yourself, take heading ideas from competitors, or use the AI writer to generate a comprehensive heading structure. Under Metadata, you can let the copywriter who will be working on the article know what the recommendations or requirements for filling in the metadata are. And if you have any additional notes, you're welcome to leave them here for the copywriter. With our SEO content brief all set up, let's go back to the Content Editor tool and start working on the article itself. Let's paste the article's heading structure that was researched by the SEO specialist during the content brief setup. This pretty much already looks like the outline copywriters usually get, and they can follow the traditional path by doing research on the topic and putting words together into sentences to ultimately create the entire text. Now, to make sure the copywriter is on the right track, we encourage them to keep a watchful eye on the panel on the right-hand side that contains tabs like Improvements, Quality, Outline, and AI Writer. This is where the content editor truly shines in terms of getting texts ready for both search engines and human readers. The Improvements tab provides information on the article's content score that takes into account both quality and relevance. It also lets copywriters know what their brief progress is in terms of the content parameters, terms to use, and links. Under the Quality tab, content creators can check to make sure that their content doesn't have any grammatical or punctuation mistakes, verify that the text isn't flooded with stop words, is unique, as in not plagiarized, and readable. The Outline tab gives copywriters the opportunity to review the content heading structure, terms, links, questions, competitors, and notes. If a heading was pulled from a competitor URL, copywriters can click through to their pages to see what exactly they wrote about. Moreover, writers can copy a piece of text from a competitor's page and leverage our AI rewriter to quickly add rival content ideas into their article, but with a unique twist. Think of it as a quick way to avoid writer's block. Copywriters can create full-fledged SEO-optimized articles using this method. However, there is one more tab we didn't get to here called AI Writer, where content creators can generate different content depending on their needs. Just click on an area in the article to decide where you want the new text to be added, click on the type of content you want to create, specify its details, and hit Generate. Another option allows you to type in a forward slash on a new paragraph and leverage the Ask AI feature to enter a custom prompt and get an AI-generated text. Furthermore, you can use this feature to get the AI to edit existing paragraphs in your text based on a custom prompt. By the way, I want to point out that the AI Writer, AI Rewriter, and Ask AI tools share the same account limit, so be sure to keep an eye on it. Besides optimizing the article yourself, you can share access to the text with a teammate, a freelancer, or a client. Plus, you can deactivate the link just by updating it. On top of that, you can export the article via the following formats: export to docs, the standard format for Word documents, export to HTML, the format suited for web browser display, export to Google Docs without moving the article, move the article to work in the Google Docs add-on, a very familiar environment for content creators, export to WordPress using the API, and generate a WXR export file for WordPress. Lastly, you can also export the brief via Excel or TXT formats. Once you finish optimizing your article, publish it, and keep track of its performance right in SEO Ranking. By clicking on a graph next to a published article whose analytics data is synced with SEO Ranking, you will see a detailed chart containing the article's number of impressions, clicks, CTR, and position. Plus, you can click Add Note right above the graph to add custom notes to your articles to easily track metric changes after they're published. Below, we can see an example where FAQs were added on October 29th and new backlinks were added on November 7th. And when you see that the article needs to be improved further, you can leverage the Optimize Existing Content option I mentioned at the beginning of the video. This option pulls the entire article into the content editor, allowing you to leverage all of the optimization suggestions to improve its search rankings.
Save your team's time and create valuable content for both people and Google using SEO Ranking's content marketing tool. If you have any questions, reach out to us or visit our knowledge base. Thank you for choosing SEO Ranking, and happy SEOing.